Costa. Replacing the injured Steven Webster at tailback, Scott Lockwood, a former junior Olympic sprint champion. Lockwood, just a freshman. Number 39, fullback Leroy Holt, a 215-pounder. He ran for 452 yards this year. At split end, SC's top receiver with 42 receptions, Eric Offholder, his biggest catch, beat UCLA. The flanker, senior Randy Tanner, has a dozen career touchdowns. Watch out, he has thrown for two touchdowns. At tight end, all Pac-10, Paul Green, he has a 20-game streak with at least one catch. The starting offensive line for Southern Cal at left tackle, the biggest Trojan, 320-pound John Guerrero. 255-pound sophomore Brent Parkinson is the left guard. SC fans say he's their next All-America lineman. At center, 250-pound John Katnick. He's from Santa Ana, California. At right guard, 260-pound freshman Mark Tucker, one of five freshmen to start for the Trojans today. And at right tackle, number 66, an All-American, Dave Cadigan, 280 pounds of power with linebacker speed. That's the starting lineup in the Cardinal and Gold of Southern California. And the Southern California Trojans will be playing on natural turf, much as their home field presents at the Coliseum in nearby Los Angeles. They're about to make their appearance. Let's go back to mid-November, East Lansing, Michigan. A big day for the Spartans. And George Perlis, who promised that in 5 years he would bring a Big Ten title and delivered against the Indiana Hoosiers. And the mass celebration, a royal celebration by the fans in East Lansing on the campus of Michigan State. Many of them are here today. 20,000 or more will be here. They're cheering for the Spartans at the Rose Bowl, and here is the starting lineup on offense for the green and white. Here's the starting lineup for the Spartans of Michigan State. At quarterback from Pompano Beach, Florida, Bobby McAllister, the lanky junior, is a serious threat both running and passing the ball. At tailback, All-America, Lorenzo White, number 34. He's the second leading rusher in the history of the Big Ten, carried over 1,000 times in his career. Sophomore James Moore is the Spartan fullback, used rarely, carried only 20 times all season. At split end, junior Andre Rison leads MSU in receiving, many of his catches acrobatic. Rison is the fastest Spartan, and number 17, Willie Boyer, a junior from Detroit, will start at flanker. At tight end for the Spartans, Mike Sargent, 241-pound senior, highly regarded as a blocker. The Michigan State offensive line is anchored by all-Big Ten tackle Tony Mandarich. He's 6'7 and 289 pounds. At left guard, 269-pound sophomore Bob Kula. The Michigan State center is Pat Shermer, named all-Big Ten and also all-academic Big Ten. The right guard, 271-pound junior from Fenton, Michigan, Vince Tata. And the starting right tackle, 285-pound senior David Houle. That's the starting lineup for the Michigan State Spartans.
The Spartans, who were last year of Duffy Doherty team in 1966, unbeaten LBJ. Lyndon Johnson was the president in 66, and that was the year UCLA upset them 14-12 and denied them a national championship.
The 74th Rose Bowl game underway, and it's Cleveland Calder at the 15. And dragged down at the 24. Dixon Edwards, number 57, in on the stop.
16 yards on the return. Michigan State well ahead of Clemson. That's yardage allowed per game, under 62 yards. That's about what Southern California gained in the first game of the season against the Spartans. Pete with Holt and the freshman Lockwood in the eye, and they come out throwing. Incomplete, and well covered the intended receiver, Eric Offholder. Harlan Bennett Barnett was one of three Spartans around the ball. Here's that defense for Michigan State. Szymanski, Nichols, Davis, and Buddy. That's a familiar name, both at Michigan State and Southern Cal. Buddy Moore, Percy Snow, just a sophomore, leading tackler, and he's a hitter. Kurt Larson are the three linebackers in the 4-3 set with Derek Reed, former starter at SMU, Barnett at the corners, two outstanding safeties in Miller and Prum. Three wide receivers for the Trojans. And they run it to Holt out to the 29-yard line, a gain of close to five.
Against this stunt 4-3 defense, SC plans to use their fullback more to try and get the quick hitter and try and catch those defensive linemen stunning.
I'm sure you'll be examining that as we go through the course of the game, Merlin Olsen, the various games, the tricks, the stunts that the Spartans use. You just never know where they're coming from.
It's basically a professional defense, a 4-3 defense, adapted to the college game.
Heat on the roll. Rodney Pete's trying to run it. No, last minute throw's incomplete. He's trying to hit Scott Lockwood, his tailback. It appeared that Pete had enough running room for a first down, and the Spartans have held, and they love it on the Michigan State side. Chris Spurl, a junior from Fountain Valley, California, averaged only 35 yards a punt, will kick for Southern California.
Number 50,
Todd Crum, an all Big Ten safety and an outstanding baseball player as well, stands at the Michigan State 30. Good kick by Spurl. Crum at his 27. And returns about nine to the 36-yard line, where Scott Brennan, the man who snapped the ball, makes the tackle for Southern California. A 44-yard punt. 8 yards on the return. Southern California will deploy this way, basically with a three-man front. Tim Ryan, the best of the three, with Don Gibson and Dan Owens. Very young defense. Marcus Cotton, he's a senior. Scott Ross, only a freshman. Davis, the leading tackler, and Stokes are the linebackers. Hale and Coet on the corners, and Coulter and Carrier, two bright young safeties. They liken them to Dennis Smith and Ronnie Lott of years ago. Lorenzo Wright gets the first call, and Don Gibson says hello for the Trojans after a short gain. Lorenzo White from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, went to Dillard High School. He's one of only 11 seniors on this entire traveling squad of 64 for Michigan State. He has rushed for over 4,700 yards in his grand career at Michigan State, second all-time Big Ten. Second and eight. White again. Bill Stokes and Scott Ross were there. And that's Ross, the freshman from El Toro High School here in Southern California. A true freshman, not a redshirt.
If you see him taking the signals from the sideline, he has the responsibility of calling the defenses. Sent down from Chris Allen, called in there. And I'll tell you, that's a lot of responsibility for a young freshman. He has played some outstanding football here late in the year.
Both teams are young, and that bodes well for their hopes in the season next fall. Bobby McAllister looks at third and seven. His first throw, apparently.
Caught from behind by Cotton, and down he goes. Marcus Cotton, he calls that a Cotton Club tackle, and he welcomes Bobby McAllister.
Cotton, the big sacker, had 10 coming into this game. That's his 11th tackle behind the line. Sweeping in from the backside. And this is the kind of play. McAllister, a little bit concerned about pulling that ball down. He won't throw it unless he has that man open. I don't think he felt the pressure from the backside. Cotton able to knock him down.
Here's a great punter, Greg Montgomery. This one is not as good as he normally will hit it. Randy Tanner. Corralled at the 32 of Southern California. 45-yard punt, a 4-yard return. Timeout. We played just over 3 minutes of this Rose Bowl game. No score.
SC is going to be able to sustain here early, but later in the game, I think their depth and power will begin to show on the other side of the line.
They come out with a double tight end, and they run the football, and a good run it is Leroy Holt, and a flag, a late flag goes down. We may have holding. 9 yards if.
Flag at the feet of John Guerrero, number 61.
Oh, it's against Michigan State. take the play and bring up second down and one instead of first and five. Well, they're going to mark it off from the end of the play.
Yeah.
We have a face mask, 5-yarder on the defense. Touchdown.
Checking other action on this January 1st, Florida State. In an outstanding game, the Fiesta late defeats the Cornhuskers, and Texas A&M in a surprise wallops Notre Dame 35-10. Double tight end Green and Galbraith with only John short yardage for Leroy Holt. Holt, a sophomore, gained 452 yards rushing. That's the most by an SC fullback since Marcus Allen played that position in 1979.
Here is the stunt 4-3. You see how the tackle, in this case, Mark Nichols, lined up inside. And what he's trying to do is protect this middle linebacker to keep the offensive lineman from getting to him. Now watch as they'll just kind of sift inside, linebacker up, hole is closed. It's very difficult to get in there and block people when you stack those tackles inside. They're both stacked in on this play.
Second down and seven, and out of the shotgun, Rodney Peak. Throws incomplete, dropping the ball with Scott Lockwood, the freshman tailback. He's the man subbing for the injured Steven Webster, injured in the final game against UCLA.
And if you wonder why they call it a stunt 4-3, watch. Watch this tackle come around this side, and this tackle go around the other side as they try to get pressure in there on Rodney Peak. A stunt right up the middle. They're gaming and stunning almost on every play.
Good throw by Pete, but Lockwood, perhaps with a little emotions affecting the play, unable to hang on to a fairly well-thrown ball. Again from the shotgun. Pete drilling the ball to run a catch down at the 41-yard line by Ken Henry, a senior from Fresno, California.
Get a feeling for the power in the arm of Rodney Pete, a fine shortstop. And he has great control of the football. Look at the accuracy of that throw. Henry was covered to the inside. Pete threw it back outside, or the only man that could catch it would be his receiver, Henry.
First down for the Trojans on the 10-yard play at the Michigan State 40. The give is the hold, and he plows for five. Other scores today on this big bowl day around the country. Clemson with a solid win over the Lions of Penn State. And at the half, Auburn trying to spoil a perfect season for Syracuse, leading 10-7. Here, no score. 10 minutes left, first quarter. Southern California, the first team to cross the 50-yard line in this first quarter. And it's second down and a long five. Fake to Holt. Pete on the option has a first down at the state 28-yard line. Brian Jones, a freshman, playing for the injured Percy Snow. Apparently Snow wobbly as he left the field a couple of plays ago.
Two things that you can do to hurt this stunt 4-3 defense, and this is one of them. Getting outside, getting that good sprint out action by the quarterback or the option to the outside. Rodney Pete able to get you that good movement, that good scrambling ability, good running ability.
Holt, he almost didn't get the handoff. In fact, that might have been a fumble the way they were scrambling. Mark Nichols, number 83, right in the thick of the play. Kurt Larson, number 3, also there for the Spartans. And as they unpile, number
SC continues to work to that quick hitting fullback as opposed to the tailback. And again, the reasoning, they're trying to catch Michigan State's defensive linemen in those stunts and split those stunts to get some yardage.
2 yards on the play. Nichols, a senior, number 83, got him from behind right around the shoulders. Ricky Irvins, a freshman, number 34, now a tailback for Michigan, for Southern Cal. Pete over the middle finds Irvins. And he's down at the 18-yard line, close to a first down.
Be about a yard short of that first down. Irvin's the quicker of those two freshmen. Is in there, of course, to use the little ability. Pete taking a shot on this play from the backside. You'll see the pressure arriving just a little bit too late. That's John Buddy coming in from his end position, put a smack on Pete, but the pass is complete. Third and short yardage.
A long one for Southern Cal. It's Holt up the middle, and he has the first down, close to the 16. Leroy Holt. Where's number 39? He admired Sam Cunningham. Remember over the top Cunningham in the 1973 Rose Bowl game against Ohio State when he scored four touchdowns? Well, Leroy Holt loved Cunningham, and where's his number 39?
Dick, apparently no one told this SC offensive line that they were going to be dominated today. Cadigan and Tucker and Katnick, Parkinson and Guerrero have done a fine job on this first drive.
10th play of the drive. With 7:50 left in the first quarter, and Pete incomplete to Holt. Well covered by Miller, number 44.
These two safeties for Michigan State. Miller is really a hitter, and Todd Crum, kind of a center fielder, a finesse player, but they're a fine set of safeties on both sides today. These two more experienced than the young SC safeties, but very important to a defense to have those kind of heady players. Both played cornerback last year, and one of the strengths of this defense was being able to move them back to the safety positions.
Off play action, Pete going for six, incomplete. Harry Hoffholder was open at the goal line. And Pete not happy with that throw.
Well, he knows if you can get it to Hoffholder, he's gonna catch it. If he can get his hands on it, he's going to pull it down.
Well, he has fantastic hands. They liken him to former star at SC Bob Chandler. Great moves and terrific hands. And Pete said that could have been a touchdown. Craig Johnson, a fifth defensive back, comes in for Michigan State on third and 10. Shotgun SC. All 11 Michigan State players within 2 yards of the line of scrimmage. Pete to John Jackson, number one, but he was well covered by Derek Reed, number six.
Dick, this is something that will really hurt SC today if they don't find a way to correct it, and that is that they were able to move the ball outside the 20-yard line very quickly down the field. But once that field got short down there, Michigan State's defense tightened up and shut them down. They'll have to go for the field goal try.
Kevin McLean, backup quarterback, will hold for Quinn Rodriguez. He's a freshman. Hit on 12 of 15 field goal attempts this year, and he put Southern California on the board. A 34-yard field goal for Quinn Rodriguez. And with 7 minutes and 28 seconds left in the opening quarter, this Rose Bowl at Southern Cal by 3. California has struck first on a 34-yard field goal by freshman Quinn Rodriguez, and he will now kick it off to Michigan State. Blake Ezor, a sophomore and a sprinter from Las Vegas, Nevada, and Craig Johnson, another sprinter, number 28, are deep for the Spartans. It's to Johnson's side at the 11. Ooh, is he drilled at the 24? Craig Hartsiker, a linebacker, number 40, really put a shoulder on Johnson.
Just, boy, I tell you, there's some hitting going on down there. This is the last game of the year. There's nothing to save it for, and both teams, I think, have that same kind of feeling. And Hartsiker, who's a backup linebacker, actually defensive end, the way Southern Cal plays, really put some meat on it.
To Johnson's credit, he did not cough up the ball. Lorenzo White and James Moore, and McAllister throws, incomplete. Intended for Willie Boyer, and Dwayne Garner, number 9, came up to bat it away.
Neither of these quarterbacks have really been on target early. We probably would expect Bobby McAllister to have a few problems, but Pete has been wild too. This one is thrown high. You pull that pass down a little bit, I don't think that ball is going to be fumbled away. You stretch a receiver out like that and you just burp him, and that ball comes rolling out.
McAllister's first pass of the game. Here's Lorenzo White, vaulting, hurtling, and fighting close to a first down. Marcus Cotton finally made the tackle after nearly a 10-yard gain.
Marcus Cotton, very important in the scheme of things today. Coming from the backside, he's going to come all the way around to get a piece of that tackle. Well, that's some great pursuit.
That's a nice touch by Cotton, number 25. He's done that himself with adhesive tape. That's in honor of Steven Webster, the tailback, who will not play today because of an injury suffered against UCLA. McAllister rolled to a first down at the 40. Greg Coet, number 46 on the corner, made the tackle. The Spartans on the move.
Both of these teams have improved since the beginning of the year, since that first game. And one of the people who has improved the most is Bobby McAllister. He's grown in confidence. He's also grown in his experience level and, very importantly, in his respect level among his teammates. Much better quarterback. Still has some improving to do in that confidence level.
Trap, and Dan Owens didn't fall for it. Number 90 from Lake Havasu, Arizona, went to La Habra High School. Number 90, Owens.
Tony Mandarich. Boy, he is a giant on the right-hand side. He's the trapper coming in. Now, that's not quite a decleater because the back appeared to miss the hole on that play. There's plenty of room in behind. The back just did not hit the proper hole.
Again, filtering his way for five to the 45. Mark Carrier, a freshman, number seven, with a tackle.
It's a team that can, well, you'll watch them coming just for, well, golly, we're hardly going to be able to see them. But let's just turn that loose and watch as you, they'll pull the two linemen from the end. That's a tight end, Sargent and Mandarich, coming around from the left-hand side to lead up through that hole. Boy, that's putting a lot of beef in front of that ball carrier.
McAllister on third and five to throw. And now the scramble. He's got five and more. And a first down at the Southern Cal 38. Bobby McAllister grew up a Dolphins fan and a fan of Bob Greasy. Well, Bob, even when he was at Purdue, didn't scramble quite that well.
Bobby was a pure drop back passer. He would have liked to have been able to run like Bobby McAllister does here. McAllister gets good distance and then gets himself out of bounds with a little assistance. But that's a big first down. Down to the 38-yard line of the SC Trojans.
Southern Cal leading 3-0 with 5:07 remaining first quarter. Lorenzo White weaving to the 31. Mark Carrier coming up from the safety spot to make the tackle.
The thing Lorenzo White does best is cut back against the grain, that very quick lateral movement. And there was a question, because he plays so much on the natural turf, it will take him a little while to adjust, or on the artificial turf, it will take him a little while to adjust to this natural turf. And there was a question as to whether he would be able to cut as quickly. He showed us some great cuts there.
Second down.
Double tight end, Mike Sargent, and number 86, Rich Gusevich. Little hesitation and goal by Lorenzo White. His idol was Walter Payton, so like so many young athletes, he borrows the number 34. Davis and Holder with a tackle. Two best all-time in their careers, and of course, the Buckeye Archie Griffin graced these lawns of the Rose Bowl as an All-America at Ohio State.
The thing that amazes me is that he has carried the ball 1,047 times. George Perlis says, he said, that's like being beaten up 1,047 times.
Running into guys like you, it is. Third and short. And diving over the top, and it's going to be close. As Scott Ross and many others there for the Trojans.
Close to a first down.
The quiet man at the bottom of that pile, Keith Davis, number 60. They're going to measure. Linebacker who leads this team in tackles, has done in two of the last 3 years, but he doesn't say a word out there. He talks with his shoulder pads and his helmet.
They will measure, as you see, the try again over the top. Joe Q, number 38. And it is a first down for Michigan State. George Perlis started using the wishbone, mixing in some added offense against the University of Michigan. But it wasn't the wishbone offense that did it. It was the luck of the defense as they intercepted 7 Wolverine passes in that victory. Deepest drive for the Spartans. They trail 3-0. Lorenzo White with the 21. Oh, he's showing some moves to that Southern Cal defense. Carrier and Colder, the two safety men with a tackle.
A chance to watch the acceleration. Look at Lorenzo White, just a quick stutter step, and then over the top. What fast feet he has. Watching behind, I think you can appreciate even more. Quick step to the left. There's the cutback ability we talked about. And I think what amazes me when I watch him is how few straight-up hits he takes from the defense.
He gets the call again. And with written out of bounds by Greg Coet inside the 20-yard line as you look at George Perlis. White is his bread-and-butter back and rushed for 111 yards against Southern California and a couple of touchdowns in that opening game 27-13 win against Larry Smith and SC. In today's game, we'll be selecting the outstanding player from each team. Budweiser will donate a total of $2,000 to the school's general scholarship funds. Third and one. The wishbone and the keeper. I don't think he made it. McAllister. And he may have fumbled, but we'll see it after the ball. SC came up with a pumpkin as Mark Carrier after the hit by Coet.
They love to run in behind Tony Mandarich and Bob Kuhl on the left-hand side of that offensive line. They came out with the option on that play with McAllister in the ball. He tried to duck inside. It's all in the mark. Watch him going to the left here. Number 63 is Kuhl. 79 is Tony Mandarich. They get outside here. But that's a fine, fine play. Ducking inside by Greg Coet, number 46. Often playing like an outside linebacker from that short side position.
Fourth and one, they're going for it. Dwayne Young, used primarily as a blocking back, as the wing to the left. White diving for the first down.
USC's short yardage defense will find them submarining. There is no way to stop this play. Look how high White goes. Looks like a 3-meter champion as he goes over the top.
Woof.
A risk, and a little more risk than we've seen George Perlis take ordinarily as he goes for the fourth down play.
13 plays on this drive, 12 on the ground. That's true to form for the Spartans. And it's true to form to give it to 34.
Lorenzo White, he's to the five.
Great running backs have the ability to see the hole, and then they make yardage on their own. Look at this as he spins away from Coet, keeps his balance, gets away from Stokes, finally taken down by Carrier. Watch the quickness here as he sees the hole and just explodes inside, getting away from Marcus Cotton in the process. Oh, that's a ballet.
First and goal, Michigan State trailing 3-0. It's White again.
He's got a touchdown.
It looked like a great block by Mike Sargent, the tight end out there, to help clear the way. A couple of defenders got caught up with each other on the line. Lorenzo White just turned on the afterburner and put it in the end zone. Interesting note, Nick Enberg, this Michigan State team, when they get ahead, they don't give you back the lead. They just keep right on going.
That was a Lorenzo White drive. He's carried 12 times already and punches it into the end zone. Langlo's extra point drive.
Michigan State leads 7-3.
A quick look at Lorenzo's play, and you'll see the stack of defenders right there on top of Sargent as he gets it over the top and into the end zone.
10 of the plays involve White's running, and he caps it with a 5-yard touchdown. He's the all-time touchdown maker in Spartan history. Broke Lynn Shadnoy's record earlier this year of 31. That was his 42nd. Cleveland Calder and Ricky Irvins will return the kick as Lorenzo White, a well-earned breather. He says, give me the ball. He ran it 56 times in the win against Indiana, and he was ready for more than the game demanded. A lot of those yards were self-earned. He got some key blocks, but he showed all of his great talent on that drive. Ricky Irvins at the 5. The young tailback out of bounds at the 25. Let's go back to the touchdown by Lorenzo White.
A couple of things to look for. Watch the great block by Mandarich coming in here, and then watch these two defenders tangle up with each other on the play. And actually, I think if they hadn't tripped over each other, that's Tex Williams, 54, a carrier, getting in each other's road and getting knocked down on the play. James Moore getting a good block in there.
Southern Cal with the ball at the 25, trailing 7-3. We're in the final minute of the opening period. And Rodney Pete on the roll. Going to run.
Rodney Pete, the keeper.
And has 6 yards to the 31. Kurt Larson, number 3, ran him out of bounds. Let's take another look at Lorenzo White and the touchdown that gave the Spartans the lead.
He's second and 4.
Yeah, we'll do that after this next play, apparently. Rodney Pete, the Trojans' most valuable player this year, hit 304 as the starting shortstop. USC's baseball team last spring. His dad, Willie, former coach under Larry Smith at Arizona, currently a Green Bay assistant coach. On second and 4, the quick pass incomplete, and Henry saw the defensive man coming. Tim Moore, number 42.
Let's go back and look at that touchdown again. And looking in behind, you get a good chance to watch the block. And I said that was Moore making the block. Actually, it's Joe Pugh who's the better blocker of those fullbacks. They've got the nice block in there. But that's the quickness and the acceleration of Lorenzo White that really made that play possible.
Third and 4. Up the middle, complete to the tight end, Paul Green. And he keeps his consecutive streak going. He's caught at least one pass in 20 straight games coming in. And Green, a junior from Fresno, picks off a pass and a first down to the 44.
Very, very quick, just short pattern, little hook up inside. When you run the zone defenses, you'll offer some room to that tight end. And SC taking quick advantage of it as Green able to find the spot to take the pass.
Pete is now 3 for 10 throwing. Again down the middle to Green. And he's at the Michigan State 47, close to another first down, a gain of about 9. Percy Snow, number 48 from Canton, Ohio, the middle linebacker, a brilliant sophomore on the stop. Final second ticks away, and that's the end of the first quarter of this 74th Rose Bowl Classic. And after 15 minutes, the Big Ten champion Michigan State Spartans lead 7-3. My coach isn't here to watch me, but he knows his spirit is there in green and white, rooting for the Spartans today. As Pete on second and 1 goes deep. Intercepted. John Miller for the Spartans at the 30-yard line.
We mentioned the two safeties, the heady play of Miller, who I think anticipated the pass. It's a throwaway down. SC is gambling. They're trying to get the ball deep. And Miller just read that play perfectly. Good movement to the ball. Takes it at the highest point and heads back upfield.
Randy Tanner, number 23, the veteran senior. They call him Gramps, made the tackle. And there's Miller, who intercepted 6 during the year. 4 of those against Michigan. And the Spartans have the ball early second quarter. Spartans without a yard passing, and most of the 67 yards rushing belong to Lorenzo White. Even balance, 40 and 40 for Southern Cal, but it's 7-3 on the scoreboard, Michigan State.
That turnover brings back sour memories for SC. Five turnovers in that first game really killed them against Michigan State.
McAllister sets him up at the Spartan 30. And slides down at the 31-yard line, a gain of a yard. Marcus Cotton, number 58, there to secure the tackle.
There was a case where I think you had McAllister feeling his way as he would on the artificial turf, not able to make that kind of cut here on what is a very good turf. In fact, I think it's the nicest football turf I've ever seen. I don't think you can compare it to anything.
It is, we're on it yesterday, and because UCLA played away in their last game, they had an extra week to seed that winter rye. It's a very firm track. Lorenzo White with a good hit in the open field. Greg Coet, a 6'3 cornerback. He'll probably play safety in the NFL. He's a senior from Burbank. Yeah, some of those great aerial shots as we've enjoyed them through the years from the Goodyear Airship Columbia, based in Carson, California. Our pilot today is Joel Chamberlain from Norwood, Massachusetts, 63rd consecutive year that Goodyear blimps have flown over major sporting events. Third down and 7 for Michigan State. Boyer way out to the right. Andre Risen, a brilliant receiver, split left, and a draw. White brought down by 99 Tim Ryan and 90 Dan Owens as the Trojans defensive line read it well, and Michigan State will have to punt.
The conservative nature of George Perlis and Morris Watts, his offensive coordinator, showing there as they don't go to the pass. They'll count on their punter, Greg Montgomery, an All-American in his second year. He's been there twice as an All-American to get them field position and put their defense back on the field.
Brandy Tanner is back at the SC 19. Montgomery has a major league foot, and he drives this one high. Tanner waiting and waiting at the 24. No flag, and Tanner returns close to the 35-yard line. Jenkins and Edwards with a tackle, a 42-yard punt, a dozen on the return. Timeout. We'll keep an eye on number 66, a reverse to Tanner. And he's to the 40, the 41, a gain of 6. Cadigan is 6'5 and 280 pounds from Newport Beach, California. And we talked about those decleaters, Merlin Olsen, where you knock a man on his back so you see the cleats in the air. He had an average of 14 a game.
Very, very strong, as you would expect for a big man, 6'5, 285. He can bench press about 485 pounds, which is the most ever pressed by an SC Trojan.
On second and short, the give is to the freshman Irvins and Tim Moore and company. Looked like a fumble, but
I think SC covered, but I believe that ball was loose momentarily, Dick.
You saw something, the color of the football might have been the bottom of the shoe.
Or a helmet.
That's right. Short of the first down and third and 2.5.
One of the things that SC misses, and not only Webster's running ability, but his experience. You put two true freshmen into a big game like this, and there have got to be a lot of butterflies on the field.
He's a tailback, Irvins, who played here in Pasadena at Muir High School. A feet to throw. Quick eyes over the head of Tanner. He was well covered by Derek Reed, and Pete goes down. I believe it was John Buddy, the defensive end, applying the pressure, and he's groggy.
You'll see Pete taking the shot here. This is a relatively quick pass. Buddy had gotten excellent penetration, and Pete waving that right arm a little bit. He's been popped a couple of times pretty hard after he's thrown.
Chris Spurl kicking to Todd Crum. Crum, outstanding athlete, a great baseball player himself. And Spurl, maybe motivated by Montgomery, kicking very well, and that one rolls all the way into the end zone for the touchback. So Michigan State with a 7-3 lead will have it at the 20-yard line when we return to Pasadena.
More than a parade, it's an event, and a national event for all of us.
That's a terrific way to start a new year. Many fans experienced it today. Here's Lorenzo White. Oh, it's twisting for eight more. In his career, Lorenzo White, 15 times, rushed for 100 yards in a half. Five of those this season. And he's on his way to a possible century mark in the first half today. Yards for White. This time it's the fullback Moore. They weren't expecting him to get the call. He toted the ball only 20 times all season. First down, Michigan State at the 37. Poet and Carrier with a tackle.
Moore, the best of the ball carriers among those fullbacks, and they really don't go often to the fullback. It's a bit of a shock as he finds some room inside. That's one of the things that Michigan State has to improve on. They want to get a couple of fullbacks who can really tote that football. The other thing they'd like to improve in that offense, their tight end position in terms of receiving. They've got good blockers in there, but they need some receivers as well at that tight end position.
Flags are down. White corralled for little or no gain. Bill Stokes, number 31. He played at Pasadena High School. Weak side linebacker was first there.
Check, this SC defense is a field perimeter defense. They try to pin you against that sideline. They stack the wide side of the field, and they say to you, we want you to have to battle the odds on the wide side of the field or go back into the short side.
It apparently is against Michigan State. It appeared to be a motion penalty.
No gain, and I think they're going to decline the penalty, at least.
There's the motion call, 5 yards, but on the play, a gain of only, well, maybe no gain at all, so we'll see if Southern Cal declines.
We have illegal motion on the offense. Penalty is refused. Second down.
10 minutes and 6 seconds left in this first half. Michigan State on the ground.
Well, we said they were a running game, a running circus. They do put it on the ground and roll it at you.
On second and 10.
Long, long throw to Rison, and he's open. All the way to the 6-yard line.
When you can force a defense to come up and play 8 men against the run, you can expect to get that man-to-man coverage. And when you have a receiver with the speed and the catching ability of an Andre Rison, and you get that ball as perfectly thrown as that, you've got one big play.
55 yards on the play. They spot it inside the 8-yard line. First and goal. Rison, who has been brilliant, finished second in the Big Ten long jump. He is a reserve on their basketball team as well. White diving to the goal line. Did he step out of bounds at the 3? Yes, apparently. That's the same play they scored on in the first quarter.
What great body control as he fought for the sideline. Dick, it's interesting to note that the SC defense has left Tony Mandarich uncovered for a good part of the day. That's the big left tackle. They're not putting a lineman in front of him, but watch him struggle down that sideline, stepping out right at the 2-yard line. The ball is marked, I guess, a little further out. Actually, out at the 3.
Double tight end.
White, touchdown!
Fiber has his second touchdown of this opening half as he caps an 80-yard drive in 6 plays. And now the try for point by Langlo Michigan State leads 14-3.
Again, sweeping out behind the left side of that line. Mandarich is right there to drive away, along with Gusevich, into the end zone without a hand on it.
Well, things have not been so pleasant for those who cheer for the Big Ten Conference champions. Only twice in 18 years. There have been a seven-year span between wins, and it's been, this would be the seventh year again. And perhaps the Spartans have the itch. At the 15, Irvins. No one to block for him. And he ad-libs his way to the 23. Let's go back to Lorenzo. He didn't have much to contend with.
Number 63, Bob Kola. 79, Tony Mandarich. 60, Pat Shermer, all getting great plays. As we turn that play loose, you'll watch them driving down, getting the good block by the fullback in there, James Moore, and there was just nobody left. When you get that kind of execution in the offensive line, you've got some real problems defensively.
So Southern Cal will have to rally from an 11-point deficit, and Pete comes out throwing. A little safety valve toss into the flat. Affolder has his first catch of this Rose Bowl, and Kurt Larson with a tackle. Lorenzo White, only an injury in his junior year, denied him perhaps the Heisman and the status that he would have deserved as truly one of the greats in Big Ten history. I mean, he'll go down as one of the best, but was held because of injuries. Just a 600-plus season last year rushing. Pete to throw again. Scrambles. Boy, some pretty running by Pete in the first down to the 38-yard line. Paul Green threw a good block on the way. And Percy Snow, they say Snow ices you with his tackles. And the sophomore put a good hit on Pete.
Number 83, Nichols, very impressive in his defensive tackle position, often double-teamed. He was in to pressure Rodney Pete, but Pete doing what he can do so well with his quickness and his running ability, able to escape the pressure and pick up some yardage.
8:45 left first half, 14-3 in Michigan State, and a sack by Travis Davis, and he knows how. He led the Spartans with 11 during the course of the year.
And he's been taking lessons from Mark Gastineau. Did you see that little sack dance he did down there?
There he is, Davis. He wears 75 because he grew up as a Steeler fan, and that was the number worn by Joe Green.
He'll come around from the backside, and one of the reasons that he gets there so often is that they really have to double-team Mark Nichols. Nichols also there almost simultaneously as the two tackles stack him up along with John Buddy.
Only seven sacks against Pete, who's such a good scrambler anyway, and Davis hooks him for one on first down. The second and long. Quick toss to the fullback Holt. Out of bounds, shy of the 40. Harlan Barnett with a tackle along with Kurt Larson. Harlan Barnett in on that tackle, number 36 for Michigan State. Trying to celebrate his birthday early. He'll be 21 years old tomorrow.
SC working at a little bit of a disadvantage. The sun low on the horizon to our right, coming into the eyes of receivers looking back at the quarterback. That's not great if you're trying to throw that ball down, and it's hard to spot against that bright, bright sunlight.
Three wide receivers on third and 10. Time on call time.
Didn't like what he saw defensively.
So he'll talk it over with Larry Smith and company with 7:56 remaining in the first half. Leading Southern California, and the Cardinal and Gold of USC a slight favorite coming in, but it's the Spartans 14-3, just under 8 minutes left in the half. And Southern Cal looking at third and 10, and Pete, after going to the sidelines, will work from the shotgun. Three of his six completions have been to the tight end Green. And that's where he goes on this play, but I believe it's short of the first down at the 46. Percy Snow, the middle linebacker, in on the tackle, a yard shy of a first down, so the punting team comes on.
A good play, and you can hurt this Michigan State defense going to the sideline, but you've got to pick up the first down, Paul Green, who's a fine athlete and a fine catcher, just did not get the required yardage.
1974, it was Ohio State beating John McKay's Southern California team, and Michigan's Bo Schembechler and the Wolverines beat Washington in 81. Todd Crum trying to help George Perlis, and the Spartans win here in 88, and a flag down on that return. No preliminary signal as yet.
It's a clip against Michigan State that's going to nullify that return.
And it'll be marked apparently from around the 20-yard line. That'll take it down to the 10.
Scott Brennan was the man who was clipped, number 64 for SC. Had good position. You just got to turn him loose. If all you can see is the back, you can't pop him.
64 is Scott Ross.
Excuse me, Scott Ross. I say Scott Brennan.
Well, you only missed by one. He's 65.
Yeah.
We have clipping on the receiving team. First down.
We mentioned it earlier, but Scott Ross, a true freshman with loads of responsibility in this defensive setup, not only starts in there at linebacker, but also calls the defensive signals. Now, that's a pretty challenging job for a true freshman, I'll tell you that.
Now, this is a key possession for the Southern Cal defense. They have Michigan State at the 10, trailing 14-3. They have to show they can stop Lorenzo White and the Spartan ground game. And White has other ideas as he's out to the 18, a gain of 8 on first down. Dwayne Garner, number 9, made the tackle. Larry Smith, who as a freshman entered the United States Military Academy, and apparently a penalty against the Spartans will nullify that 8-yard carry.
Lorenzo White shaking his head a little bit. Said, come on, guys, let's not lose our advantage here by making mistakes. Another thing that you know about George Perlis, lectures this team about doing things properly. He's very proud of this team. Tremendous work ethic. He said they've only had one bad practice all year, a really bad one, and that was in the rain. I think that's the practice you saw.
At UC Irvine, which was their home base for practice facilities the past weeks here in Southern California, the half the distance takes it only to the 8-yard line, so from the spot of the foul. So it is first and 12. White, who just tripped up by number 60, Keith Davis, the Trojans' leading tackler of the past year, and twice in his career at SC, he led his team in tackles and was second last year as a junior. Good student, better than a B average in business finance, and twice a Pac-10 all-academic player. Second and 9. Gets a block from Lorenzo White, but in trouble and goes down under the pressure of Dwayne Garner at the 8-yard line.
For most teams, second long yardage, third long yardage would be passing downs. Not necessarily for this Michigan State team. Again, you've got to remember, they're still not wanting to put too much pressure on Bobby McAllister to throw that football back up into his own end zone. They would rather try and run the ball out a little bit, kick it away, use the strength of their All-American punter, Greg Montgomery, and turn it back to their defense.
They come out in a pass set with both Boyer and Risen to the left. And give instead to Lorenzo White, and it didn't fool Dan Owens. The sophomore tackle, defensive end, makes the play at the 5.
We're not the only ones who recognize those tendencies for the Michigan State offense. SC pounces very quickly. They've got him backed up. And Greg Montgomery will kick from right near the back line of the end zone. And that always makes the punter nervous.
There's Montgomery, a freshman at Penn State, then transferred to Michigan State, where his dad played, wore the same number, 23 for the Spartans. Tanner is at midfield. A low line drive kick. Tanner coming up to get it at the 48. And SC has excellent field position at the 37 as Montgomery's kick returnable and not as deep as he's normally accustomed to rooting him out.
Look how quickly SC's defense goes after this running play. Good job. Inside out right there by Owens. He rides into the ground.
So USC stops Michigan State's running game, and they're in Michigan State territory. They've won more Rose Bowl games by far than any other team, 18, and they've been in 25. That's a third of all games played. Leroy Holt on first down earns a couple. So it'll be second and 8 for Southern Cal at the Michigan State 35. 5 minutes remaining. First half, 14-3. Larry Smith's Trojans trail Michigan State. Smith, who we said started at the military academy, said, I flunked Spanish. Isn't it interesting? I'd finally wind up in Tucson coaching the University of Arizona, where you had to use that language. Went to Bowling Green. He was an offensive and defensive end. Grew up under the Woody Hayes feeling. Bo Schembechler hired him as an assistant at Miami of Ohio, then took him to the University of Michigan.
He throws another interception. Kurt Larson has it at the Michigan State 27. Travis Davis applying the pressure on Pete. And that's the second Spartan interception.
USC had done so well since that first game against Michigan State at avoiding the turnovers. But that's the second interception thrown by Pete. Good positioning on this play by Larson as he just slips back in front of Appholder, who dropped in into a little hook. Well, that's a short way to bring a drive up. You see Pete talking it over with the coach on the sideline.
And Southern California, after the 5 turnovers, played such error-free ball the rest of the way to earn their trip to Pasadena. Best in the nation, a plus 17 on the turnover table, despite the fact that it was Michigan State plus 2 in that first game. The Spartans coughed it up 3 times to SC's 5. Boyd by that interception. Michigan State with a lead 14-3. Lorenzo White with 3 more yards on his 22nd carry of the first half. He has 80 yards.
Dick, as we look out at this beautiful day, I was just thinking, trying to think with that Michigan State coaching staff on the sideline, and I'm sure the kind of team that they have, they would have rather played this game in a blizzard because they're a cold weather team. They run the football, they play tough defense, and they do low risk things. But here they are on a beautiful and brilliant football day
and playing to the caliber to match that day. This is Blake Ezor, and for the first time, and Ezor hit by Scott Ross. Ezor is from Las Vegas, Nevada. He's 5'8", a sophomore, went to Bishop Gorman High School. There was the Nevada Play of the Year. And it's interesting how he and Michigan State got together. George Perlis and his dad became friends. His dad was a casino employee at the Dunes Hotel there. They became friends, and finally his dad said, hey, my son's not a bad player. You ought to take a look at it. And it was time well spent. Ezor will fill the shoes of Lorenzo White next year, and they really like him. McAllister off play action, eludes the rush. And the second wave gets him back at the 23.
You sense the inexperience of McAllister. He still pulls that ball down a little bit early, but he doesn't throw many interceptions, and I think that's something they're pleased about. They'd rather have him pull it down a little early rather than throw it away and throw the interception.
Well, the Southern Cal defense has stopped Michigan State as Cotton and Owens collaborated on that last tackle, and here's Greg Montgomery. We still yet to see Montgomery really hit one of his patented high long jobs. Tanner stands with respect way back at the 25.
In fact, Montgomery's last kick was a low line driver, the kind you don't want to see your punter get off. There's one.
He hits that one a ton.
There's one
to the 17. And Tanner gets it to the 30. Mike Iaquinella makes the tackle. A 60-yard kick for Greg Montgomery.
Larry Smith, watch him as he watches that ball go up into the air. It's still up. Larry, it's still up there. Now, there it comes. Now it's down.
a Ruthian.
Now that's body English, I think, right there. Larry Smith's home is right up here above the Rose Bowl at La Cañada. He wakes up every morning, and when it's a clear day, looks down at this stadium. I'm sure that did a great deal to reinforce his goal for this season.
Gale Gardner will run down all the scores and highlights of this big bowl day, this January 1st at halftime. Stay with us. Trailing 14-3. Pete. Oh, that went over one SC receiver to another and caught by John Jackson. He's a sophomore from Diamond Bar, had 34 catches this year and led the receivers for the Trojans with 7 touchdowns.
Looking in over the heads of the linebackers from the backside, and this is what a Calvin Pete's running ability and confidence can do for you. He'll wait and wait. Well, and he'll get the ball again live as he gets the ball out to the outside. Very quickly.
The tailback picks up a first down at midfield. 1:40 left in the first half, and so USC on that last play, working without a huddle, trying to conserve time, trailing Michigan State 14-3. The emotions of this game so important now, these final 2 minutes. Michigan State trying to stop the Trojans, go into that locker room with a sizable lead, and Southern Cal trying to build some momentum by getting some points before the half.
And the one thing we do know about this SC team, with Rodney Pete and a passing attack, they can come from behind. They can sting you from behind.
Michigan was ahead last year in the first half, you recall. Before halftime, Arizona State able to, whoop, what is that? It's a pass, and Leroy Holt catches it.
That's almost a serious mistake by Rodney Pete. As he was hooked from the back, they had a hold of his shirt, and he tried to just flip the ball out to get it out to one of his running backs. They're coming back with no huddle very quickly. Second, 11 and a half, 12 yards to go.
To the sidelines, to Lockwood again, out of bounds at the State 44. Short of the first down by 5 yards with 1:10. Clock stopped, but now SC also looking at third down.
SC used one of their timeouts earlier, as Rodney Pete didn't like what he saw with the defense. They still have 2 left on the board. Moving the ball now inside of the 45-yard line. They'd like to get something. They'd obviously like a touchdown, but I think they might even take a field goal if they can get a shot at it here.
Michigan State adds Craig Johnson, a nickel defensive back in, takes out linebacker Larson. Deep down the middle to Jackson, incomplete and broken up by Todd Crum.
When Nick Saban, the defensive coordinator for these Spartans, talked to me about his team, one of the guys he's so proud of is Todd Crum. He said this is a smart football player. He reads the quarterbacks. In fact, he thinks like a quarterback. You'll see it here. Look at the timing. Crum, watching the eyes of the receiver, delivered the blow before that ball could be tucked away and shook it loose.
Well, the Spartans deny Southern Cal and spoil the punt.
Into the end zone.
Crum lets it fly. Whoa, Southern Cal saves it at the 4.
Smart play by Mark Carrier, number 7. Looked like he volleyballed that ball back. It was headed into the end zone. He got there and just tapped it back. Watch number 7. Right there, just within about 6 inches of being on the end line, taps that ball back. Very, very smart special teams play.
And Scott Ross downs it at the in the Orange Bowl tonight. Lorenzo White drilling out to the 13-yard line. Final seconds of the first half. 9 more for White, who now is at 89 yards for the half and 2 touchdowns.
Marcus Cotton, they're coming to his side as he tries to work to the tight end right there. Get away from Sargent. He gets away from Sargent, but he gets a load of Lorenzo White, who's got them out to where they have a little breathing room, and I'm sure they're just going to run out the clock here and take that 14-3 lead on into the locker room.
Another carry for White for literally no gain. And that apparently will be the end of the first half. And Michigan State played it the way they earned their way to this Rose Bowl. Tough defense, solid ground game led by that man, Lorenzo White, who has the game's both touchdowns. And it's the Spartans who lead the field with the halftime lead. Michigan State, the slight underdog with a 14-3 advantage at the intermission.
for 22 passing on the day. He has 88 yards, but two critical interceptions. And boy, they are costly. The two turnovers you see right there.
Both were in Michigan State territory.
Exactly, and they stopped drives. Now, Michigan, on the other hand, only one completed pass. That one, a bomb to Risen for 55 yards to set up a touchdown. The critical thing here, 89 yards rushing for Lorenzo White. And they have been able to do what they wanted to do today, which is to control the line of scrimmage. Now, SC is going to have to step back out and try and get some turnovers for themselves. They're going to have to try and do a better job of throwing the football. The pressure is still on Rodney Peete. And if Lorenzo White and Michigan State have their say here, you'll see a lot more rushes in the second half. There's the yardage right there, the whole USC team. And they've only had one rush from either of the freshman tailbacks. Urban's carried one time. Lockwood has yet to carry in this game. First series so important, both on offense and defense, to set the tempo for the second half. Dick, you mentioned Lorenzo wanting to carry it a lot of times. Earlier this year, he set an NCAA record by carrying it 102 times in back-to-back games. So he's not afraid to take that pumpkin. It was John McKay who said, it's not heavy, let him carry it. But well, Michigan State believes.
He's a Southern California kind of back.
The second half opens. When Rodriguez kicks it to Craig Johnson, and Johnson of Michigan State to the 26-yard line. 23 yards on the return, and here comes Bobby McAllister, the quarterback, and Lorenzo White, his primary weapon. White, who scored both touchdowns from 5 and from 3 yards out in the first half. The only SC score as they got on the board first on a 34-yard field goal by Quinn Rodriguez. James Moore, the fullback, White at tailback, and it's White who carries first. No surprise there, but SC is waiting. Tim Ryan, a sophomore from San Jose, number 99. He's had an outstanding year on this young defense.
We talk about the lack of passing for this Michigan State team. One guy who's really been hurt by that is Andre Risen. And I really believe, Dick, if he were in a USC uniform, with a quarterback throwing to him as often as Peete throws, he would be an All-American.
Well, he had 54 catches as a sophomore, a Michigan State record. Play action. And finally, Marcus Cotton sacks McAllister. That's the third SC sack today.
A coverage and experience sack. Good coverage, but most of all, the inexperience of the young quarterback just does not have that confidence back there to step up maybe and get a little extra time or to just fire that football out of there.
But he didn't make the mistake, and undoubtedly that's part of the plan as well.
They love him for that. They love him for that. And turnovers, as we said, such a critical part of the earlier game. 5 SC turnovers killed them in the first game. They've turned it over twice here. No turnovers for Michigan State.
White on third and long. And SC there to stop him cold again. Greg Collette, a senior from Burbank, number 46. He's their run support cornerback and has done that brilliantly all season long. The number 2 tackler for the Trojans this year.
Michigan State wanted to challenge Collette. They didn't think that he was that good a tackler. Well, he certainly proved that he could tackle on that play. I think White made a bad choice going outside. It looked like there was room up inside on that last play.
Well, he's a senior. SC wishes he were a sophomore. Tanner deep at the 22. Ooh, Montgomery
low.
Just gets it over Carrier's reach. Takes a nice bounce, though, for Michigan State all the way to the 30-yard line.
SC's defense able to do, I'm sure, exactly what Larry Smith asked them to do. He said, let's go out and take that football away from Michigan State. Let's put our offense back on the field, and let's do something seriously with that ball.
For those of you who have been away from football today, here are the scores, the finals of Fiesta. Florida State late to win that one with a touchdown. 35-10 Clemson surprises Penn State, a 16 all tie Syracuse and Auburn. Texas A&M a big winner. Freshman from
Boulder, Colorado gets the first call and picks up about three, maybe four. Percy Snow. That name Snow, for you historians of the Rose Bowl, was one that will click in. Neil Snow, back in 1902, only Harry Coyle, our director, can remember that.
Harry knows.
Neil Snow scored five touchdowns for the University of Michigan as they beat Stanford 49-0 in the very first Rose Bowl Classic. There's Percy, a sophomore from Canton, Ohio.
Takes those calls from the sideline, calls some defenses in there. He is not a big linebacker, but he really can move, and he can hit you and hurt you.
Pete fires quickly, and it's Eric Lotholder who has a first down at the 43. Harlan Barnett with a tackle.
You can hurt this Michigan State defense with those quick patterns to the outside. Their philosophy is to keep that ball in front of them. They're a conservative-style defense. And what they're counting on is letting you make the mistake, letting you self-destruct as you work your way down the field.
Wide receivers bring in the plays for Southern Cal, so it's Tanner in there now. And into a stone wall, and maybe a fumble, as Mark Nichols is in the midst of it for Michigan State, and the Spartans think they have it. No word yet. Oh, Southern Cal in the bottom of the pile, able to gain possession.
I asked Mark Nichols, when he lines up in so tight, look how tight he is right there on the center. I said, how do you control or feel where that ball is going? He said, you do it all by a sense of feel. Look how he stuffs that hole for Lockwood, drives the center right back into the hole, and just stuffs that whole play. Boy, that's outstanding play, and that's the stunt 4-3 defense at its best right there.
Ball was sitting right there after Lockwood fumbled, but Michigan State could not recover. Keith scrambling, looking for help. Flag is down, and the completed pass of Appholder way down at the Michigan State 30, but will it count?
I think we may have a clip outside of the legal clipping zone. One of the linemen went down. Yep. Illegal block in the back.
Keith gave you an idea, though, why he's so dangerous with his speed and ability to elude the rush and then throw on the run, a long throw on the run.
Appholder working well after the quarterback breaks free, and you see him running the same direction as his quarterback, and they're trained. They work at that. What do we do after the play breaks down? Here's Pete showing you that scrambling ability. Here's the first play, nothing there. He gets a second play, and there was the illegal block right there.
For Southern California,
we have illegal use of the hands on the offense.
Dave Cadigan, their All-America tackle, is out of the game. We have no report on the injury, and Mark Sager has replaced him, number 69, and that's a huge loss in more ways than just size for Southern Cal. Deep down the middle to Jackson, and he's got this one for a first down at the 34. John Jackson, whose father was a former USC assistant coach for 5 years under John Robinson.
There's protection enough for Pete. Oh, boy, that's threading the needle. Three defenders perimetered around Jackson, but Pete brought it to the inside for the reception.
In fact, he went to the same high school, Bishop Amott, that sent J.K. McKay, John McKay's son, to USC. Holt running into the green wall. A yard gain at best. Travis Davis and Tim Moore.
Early in the ball game, SC was able to use the fullbacks on those quick hitters right up inside and try and split those stunts in the defense. Obvious adjustments by the green defense of Michigan State have made that much more difficult.
Look in that huddle. Number 66 has returned. Dave Cadigan back in there at tackle for the Trojans, who trail 14-3, 9:42 left, third quarter. Pete under pressure, throwing deep for Henry. Touchdown!
It George Perlis got to write the script for the first half. His team controlled it, running, controlled it, defense. Larry Smith wrote the script to begin the second half. He said, let's take the football away, and then let's throw the football for a touchdown. And here it is.
Perfect throw as he laid it right over the defensive back's arms and into the waiting grasp of Henry for the 33-yard touchdown. Rodriguez try for point is good. Southern Cal and Larry Smith right back in the thick of it, 14-10. Six-play drive belonged to Pete's passing, and it's 14-10 Michigan State as Rodriguez kicks it to Craig Johnson. Oh, as he drilled at the 23. Let's go back and look at the play.
Michigan State's defense is not a blitzing defense, but Rodney catches them in the blitz on this play, knows he's got man-to-man coverage on the outside, and just fires that ball perfectly to get the lead right there on Henry, who is just going to beat his man right up the sideline. And no question about that. That's Harlan Barnett. He's running for all he's worth and almost got a finger on that football. That's the one place that this Michigan State defense hurts a little bit, is in the speed of that defensive backfield.
9:29 left in the third quarter. Michigan State's lead down to four. McAllister ducking down at the 24. Keith Davis in there to spoil the fun for Michigan State.
Dick, one of the things that SC's defense has done consistently during the day is leave Tony Mandarich uncovered. They would rather have him looking for a linebacker than sacrifice one of their down linemen to him. And so far it's been pretty effective. I think he's a little frustrated. He'd like somebody to work on and put those cleats up in the air. Get a couple of de-cleaters.
Blake Ezor, number 26, in a tailback. This is Ezor. Right into Cleveland Coulter, number 8, the safety man. What a hit by the sophomore from Tempe, Arizona. On the first series, White won, and a 3-yard sack, and they're having trouble running this time.
If we run this slowly, you'll see from the right-hand side, you'll just get a feeling. Just open it up and run it nice and slowly. There comes our big tackle right there, driving like a snowplow. He's got a Mandarich is just pushing everything inside.
McAllister throwing. Complete to Mike Sargent, his tight end. And he's out of bounds right at the sticks. Stokes and Poet with the tackle. It apparently is a yard short of a first down as Sargent has his first grab of the day.
That'll bring on the punting team. And SC's defense, the first two series of this second half, it's been three and out. You can't ask your defense to do more than that unless they can maybe take the ball away. That wouldn't be so bad either.
Well, McAllister and the offense unable to move for Michigan State. Greg Montgomery, the punter, is in.
Number 23, Randy Chatter.
Montgomery, who is an outstanding kicker, and even at that trying to improve, went from a three-step to a two-step during this past season. Tanner has it at the 24. Hit immediately, and a good solid tackle by Sargent, who was downfield. Or was that Percy Snow? It was Snow, number 48, a 44-yard kick. Timeout.
Tanner returns it to the 31-yard line.
Happy New Year, and let's hope it's a continuation of all the peace talks that we heard at the end of 1987.
Rodney Pete is thinking continuation here, too.
Lockwood, little misdirection in the tailback.
Scott Lockwood.
Down rudely. Larson. And Snow, the linebackers.
Freshman getting a chance to carry the ball. Two carries so far in this second half. Had zero opportunities in the first half. Michigan State has to get something going emotionally here. They've been flat so far here in the second half. They need to get a big play somehow defensively, get something going offensively, get themselves back pumping again in this second half.
Half holder to the right, Tanner to the left. Second and 8. The sidelines to Affolder at the 40. It'll be very close to a first down.
So far in this second half, Rodney Pete really seems to have settled down. Threw some bad passes in that first half. Overthrew some, seemed to hurry a few passes. maybe getting that long bomb and that touchdown will loosen him back up. That was a perfect pass, and that's the kind of pass that Michigan State's defense is vulnerable to.
Third and inches.
This is Holt. First down at the 48 of the Spartans.
Some outstanding blocking as what would have been a short play ends up a long play because nobody is there to pick up the pieces. 42, Tim Moore misses a chance at a tackle. And Leroy Holt is having a fine day here, getting a lot of chances to carry that football.
12 yards on that attempt. And SC is in Michigan State territory.
Oh, what a toss to Lockwood. Pulls his way to the 36 and another SC first down.
That almost looked like a fumble the way Pete popped it out of there.
You want to wait until the last second to throw that on the option. Pete is just given a little option coming down. He realized there was no chance there. They were right on top of him, able to flip it out to Lockwood, and freshman knows how to run with the football, I can tell you that.
6.5 minutes remain, third quarter. SC trailing Michigan State 14-10. Lockwood again.
9 more yards against the best team against the rush in college football.
USC's offensive line up front ripping a nice hole. Katnick, Parkinson, and Tucker right in the middle. And of course, that's Cadigan, the All-American, getting the good block on the outside. Crum finally comes up to make the tackle, but this is a ripping gain. Well, I tell you, they have really changed the momentum here in this second half.
The last three running plays have gained 12 yards, 12 yards, and 9 yards. Holt, enough for a first down at the 24.
Leroy Holt.
One of the problems that USC anticipated, if they had to lean exclusively on the passing attack, was the difficulty once they crossed that 20-yard line. If they can continue to run like this, they can punch it in Michigan State style.
Tanner comes out to the left. Henry, the touchdown catch earlier in this quarter, to the right. Ricky Irvins has replaced Lockwood in the backfield. Pete. Sacked by Joe Bergen, a senior from Elmhurst, Illinois. He started the first 7 games of the Spartan season, suffered a shoulder injury, has recouped, and what a thrill for him, not only to be able to play today, to make a big play.
Certainly was a big play. Rodney Pete looking to get that short roll out of there. They just cut him up, got in there so quick he didn't have any chance to move to the outside, and Bergen able to put him on the ground.
Second down. 16.
Lots of running room. And Pete is to the 21-yard line. 22, let's call it. Tim Moore made the tackle after a gain of 8.
So it'll still be third down and about 8 yards to go for Southern Cal. Let's see as they bring in the third and 8 will be the call. I don't know, is it just me, Merlin Olsen, but just in this drive, it appears that Southern California, the fresher team, Michigan State getting up a little more slowly on.
I think the emotional level is what has changed, Dick, and of course that shows in what you do physically on the field.
Reverse to Tanner. And it was Larson who was tall enough to deny Tanner the leaping Lena for a first down. He has to settle for 5, and here comes the field goal unit on for Southern Cal. Quinn Rodriguez kicked a 34-yarder earlier.
You try and hit a disciplined defense with this kind of misdirection because you know they're trying to stop the play. They're eager. They're flowing quickly. They're lucky they didn't get more yardage. The SC didn't get more yardage because that was so well set up. Great play on the outside.
Kevin McLean, he can throw the ball as the holder.
There it is. It's a fake.
He's in trouble. Has to throw left-handed.
Intercepted.
And it's intercepted by Joe Bergen. A flag is down.
if it's against the defense, I think there'd be enough for the first down.
It was thrown in the defensive backfield. The fake field goal not only didn't work, a right-handed thrower wound up tossing it left-handed. But let's see if the penalty is against Michigan State. Apparently not.
And that kind of play may be enough to shift the momentum back.
We had illegal procedure on the offense. The penalty is refused. First down.
So that will go as a third pass interception against Southern Cal.
Here is the fake, and it's not a mishandled punt. It is obviously a called fake, and Michigan State not fooled at all. Body English did not help on that one.
Not what he had in mind. I'll get it back to you next week, I promise. Well, McAllister going deep down the middle to Risen off his fingertips. So George Perlis trying to cross up Southern California's defense as he goes to a pass on first down.
Knowing that they would find USC expecting the run, they took a chance, and that was a pass that could have been completed, not as well thrown as it should have been, a little bit high, but Risen capable of bringing that one down. A missed opportunity for Michigan State.
White is the tailback. This is his call. Carrier and Colder, the two safeties, and others to stop Lorenzo White, who's right at that 100-yard rushing mark, six shy now, 94 on the game.
A little misdirection on that play as the backs were stepping to the left to try and get those linebackers to flow and then coming back against the grain on the right-hand side.
Under 3 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Michigan State 14, Southern California 10. This is the third down and five. Fake to White. And McAllister has to eat it at the line of scrimmage. Dan Owens, number 90. Sophomore's had a big game.
Bobby McAllister again breaking down and trying to get out of that pocket a little too quick. Did not really spend much time looking at his receivers. He's got a progression that he did not use on that play.
Run by Montgomery to Tanner. 40.
50. One man to beat, the punter. And the punter, Montgomery, slowed him down enough that Aya Quinello can make the tackle, but it's SC at the Michigan State 32.
Well, the opportunity to take charge for Michigan State dissipated. And now USC roars back with a big play from Tanner here. He cuts back against the grain, pulls out of a couple of tackle attempts to set SC in great field position.
41-yard return. Recon Television Live and the other countries, 36 of them, viewing this Rose Bowl Classic. Dominican Republic, Finland, Yugoslavia, France, Germany, Italy, Luxembourg, Netherlands, Puerto Rico, Sweden, Venezuela, United Kingdom. I'm enjoying this great collegiate football game. Let's listen to how others are calling the action from Pasadena.
Son de las Rosas, los Troyanos, de la Universidad del Sur de California. En la yarda 32, primero y 10. Buena marcha ofensiva. Rodney Peter, número 16, se sale del bolsillo de protección, corre lateralmente, suelta riflazo, incompleto el pase.
You can't fool me, Dick. That's you. That's you with an accent.
You saw my lips moving. Well, let me try it in Japanese this time.
All right, let's see how you do in Japanese.
さあ、今のがノーゲインで、ボールオンは32ヤード、セカンドダウンの攻撃。後半に入って完全にリズムを掴んでいます、USC。この後はどういった攻撃を見せるのか。非常に後半に入ってパスとランのバランスが良くなってきました USC です。
まあ、今度はアイフォーメーションですからね、おそらく41番のですね、ロックウッド、これのランだ、あっと違った
パスですね、さあパスインコ
Well, I formation and incomplete, our international terms.
And we do know about those. And incomplete it was, as Affolder went high in the air, got a hand on that football. Michigan State defensive back also had hands on that football. That was Barnett that almost came away with the interception. Third down. Big, big down.
Yeah, USC on its last possession down inside the 20 and gave it up on the fake field goal. And now third and 10 after the punt return by Tanner. Pete down the middle. Affolder. Incomplete. Well covered by Todd Crum, and that was a battle of two outstanding athletes.
What a great play by Crum, using his body to crowd the receiver. You'll see it. He's at the top of your screen, number 35. Picks the man right here. Watch him. Gets a little push there. Moves up high with the ball. Boy, I tell you, that's good football on both sides. You saw Affolder grabbing at the arms to keep Crum from intercepting on that pass.
Rodriguez will try a 49-yard field goal. This is a bit out of his range. Longest this year was 42. Got plenty of leg, but it's wide to the right. So two visits into Michigan State territory for USC. After they had scored a touchdown, they come away empty. It remains 14-10.
Larry Smith knew he was on the side. He could tell that that ball drifting out to the right was not going to be good. And I'm sure George Perlis on that sideline thinking, I've got to light a fire under this team. Get them moving here.
State takes over at the line of scrimmage, the 32. Bryson out to the left. Lorenzo White. A couple, maybe 3 yards to the 36. Don Gibson and plenty of other white shirts there. For Michigan State, with that dominating ground game of the first half, it's been SC putting the blocks on them. Three tries and punt for Michigan State on their first three possessions of this second half.
This is their best field position of the second half. They possibly can be a little more aggressive in this situation.
White.
Oh.
For a couple, and that puts him over 100 yards for the day. Keith Davis tripped him up.
And I think an example, too, again, of the natural turf. I think on the artificial turf, you're able to get that quick step and catch your balance a little quicker. Lorenzo White, as you mentioned, over 101 yards. Watch him as he staggers toward the end of this run. I don't think it's a matter of being tired. The foot is touched here. He just tries to take that quick little jab step, and on the artificial turf, you're able to get that quick balance and then push on. You don't quite have the advantage here on the national on the natural turf.
23 times in his career over 100 yards. Lorenzo White has both of the Spartan touchdowns. And he's got a first down. Holder finally gathered him at the 44.
Number 99, Tim Ryan, was out there waiting for White. White just shifted gears and turned it inside and left Ryan holding air. Watch him. It looks like he is in a dangerous position here. Nowhere to go. There was the chance right there by 99 Ryan. Chance to do something with that football, and he picks up the first down of the second half for Michigan State.
And it comes on the final play of the third quarter. After three of this Rose Bowl, Michigan State 14, Southern California 10. We'll be back after these messages from your local station. While we were away, George Perlis asked his team, are you against me or for me? And so they said, I'm for you. There's four fingers.
That four is significant. 4-point lead, and we're into the fourth quarter.
And here's how the scoring developed in this Rose Bowl. Rodriguez with a 34-yard field goal for USC. Then Lorenzo White, 5 yards around the left side. 7-3 into the first quarter. White again, 3 yards untouched to make it 14-3 at the half. In the third quarter, Rodney Pete to Ken Henry, a 33-yard touchdown pass to pull the Trojans within four. Then two other opportunities as he drives into Michigan State territory. One ended on a failed fake field goal, and the other on a missed 49-yard field goal try by Rodriguez. And now it's Michigan State with the ball on first down to open the final quarter. And Out of bounds goes Lorenzo White. Coet with a tackle at the 47.
SC really owned the third quarter statistically, as Michigan State was not playing the kind of defense or offense that they had played early in the game. And the statistics will verify that they have really taken an edge in the yardage numbers. But unfortunately, those yardage, you look at that 100 yards rushing, boy, that is a big jump from where they started earlier. But yardage doesn't get you points on the board.
A team that allowed only some 61 yards rushing per game to the opposition, that is a significant total of 100 by Southern Cal, as White pushed out of bounds by Bill Stokes and Mark Carrier, shy of the 50. It'll be third and about five.
You saw Michigan State players holding up four fingers a few minutes ago, and one of the reasons I think they wanted to do that was to remember that they have dominated in the fourth quarter. 7 of 11 opponents have been held scoreless this year in the fourth quarter. And I'm sure right now they're thinking about maybe getting some points and then turning that defense loose. But they've got to get something moving here on this critical third down.
Joe Pugh with White.
Wide open is Willie Boyer. All the way to the SC 22. And I believe he was a secondary receiver. He was looking for Lorenzo White in the left flat, but White had fallen down or was knocked down, so he went to Boyer.
USC committing 8 people to the line, even on this running situation. A one-on-one situation for Boyer on the outside. And he's taking advantage of it right there. That's Dwayne Garner who finally takes him out of bounds. But a big first down down at the 23-yard line.
29 yards on the play to Boyer. His first catch. Junior from Detroit. He caught only 6 for the entire year.
You don't want a team that runs as many times as this team if they're not going to throw it to you too many times. Bobby McAllister has to feel pretty good about that. He hasn't had many completions to cheer about today.
Stevens Montgomery, the brother of the kicker Greg, is in at fullback. And Lorenzo White follows him for a couple.
Marcus Cotton there to finally put the stop on him. And not a great deal of yardage on that play. George is stomping on that sideline. You feel his intensity.
Don't know if he's mad at the officials or at his players.
Maybe both. I don't think he's happy with the way this second half has gone. He's pleased, I'm sure, to be ahead on the scoreboard, but knows that he's got to get better performance out of his offense and his defense.
2nd and 8. McAllister looking for Risen. He's covered. Risen coming back now, but McAllister is on a scramble to the 21. Really? Don Gibson with the tackle.
That's a lot of yardage to get back to the line of scrimmage, and I think that's exactly where he ended up, showing some nifty running, but again showing the insecurity of a quarterback who's really not had a great deal of success at throwing the football. Got one receiver, looks to the outside, nobody home, does a good job of rolling away and getting downfield here, but all he did really was get back to the line of scrimmage.
Say lost a yard, so that's the 5th sack for the Trojans. Brings up 3rd and 8. Or for the Spartans, 3rd and 8, and White goes down again. 99 Tim Ryan. He's a name to remember. 2 more years to play here at Southern Cal. He's 6'5", 250. This year he had 5 sacks, 1 interception, 10 tackles for losses, 5 deflected passes.
They're trying to get a little misdirection there. They start inside, and SC's down lineman coming hard as they penetrated and were able to knock White right off his feet as he cut back against the grain.
Utica, Michigan freshman John Langlow, who was 15 for 22, will try a 41-yard field goal. Oh, plenty of leg, and it is good. Officially 40 yards, and Michigan State builds its lead to 17-10.
Langlow showing us some real power on this shot, and it was good all the way.
Michigan State a 17-10 lead with 12 and a half minutes remaining, and Langlow kicks it off. It chases Irvin's into the end zone, and the ball through the end zone. that last time out. Bobby McAllister
doesn't look very happy, and I'm sure they're saying patience, have some patience in there. Don't be so quick to pull that ball down and scamper out of there. Look for those receivers. When you're committing as many people as defensively as SC is to the line of scrimmage, you're going to have good one-on-one matchups downfield. You've got to find them and take advantage of them.
Henry to the left, Tanner to the right, Holt and Lockwood in the eye behind Pete. Middle to the tight end, and Paul Green with his fourth catch stopped at the 29. 9-yard pickup. Percy Snow was their first for Michigan State.
We talked about the conservative nature of this MSU defense. Todd Crum on that last play sneaking back just before the ball was snapped, kind of pedaling back a little bit. He's the center fielder, doesn't want to let anything really get behind him, but as he pedaled back, they were able to hit the receiver for a nice gain in the mid zone.
That's the fifth catch for Green. That's a first down for Lockwood, and boy, he was streaking to the 38-yard line. McAllister has completed three passes all afternoon for Michigan State, and Green has five for SC. Just as Michigan State, as you pointed out, Merlin Olsen, tough defensively in the fourth quarter, SC has been outstanding offensively.
On that last play, USC did what they'd hoped to do earlier in the game. They split one of the stunts on this Michigan defense to get that yardage.
First down at the 38. Pete to Tanner. Michigan State 47, first down.
Talk about getting a pass off under pressure. Mark Nichols, number 83, all over Rodney Pete. Watch him right here. Just blows by the guard. And he's on Pete in a fraction of a second, but Tanner was open, and Pete got the football to him.
Tanner from Belinda, California, went to Bishop Amat High School. Pete throwing on first down. Dumps it out to Holt. Nice throw. And the fullback has another first down at the 36.
That's an example of the athletic ability and the ball control that Rodney Pete has. When he gets hot, he can put that football almost anywhere. He has such a good arm and a good feel for the ball. Just dropped it in, a little finesse pass to get that first down. Temperature's dropping here as the conditions change, but Dick, it remains a perfect day to throw the football. No wind, beautiful day, no moisture on the field. Pete having a better quarter here as he gets things underway.
He's now completed 16 passes to match the number on his uniform, but calls timeout here. Just under 11 minutes remaining in the Rose Bowl. Michigan State by a touchdown. Is tomorrow, followed by UCLA North Carolina basketball. Trojans dominating in the second half, but they've only outscored Michigan State 7-3.
You don't want to take a nap in that locker room at halftime.
First down, Southern Cal. Ricky Irvins. And Harlan Barnett coming up to support from a corner. Percy Snow and another tackle for Michigan State. John Buddy was there also, no gain.
Dick, an interesting note, and perhaps it shows that we have come quite a ways. We've not talked about the fact that starting in this game are two black quarterbacks. It wasn't too many years ago, you just didn't see many black quarterbacks in major college football. Now there are 16, and some of them are the most dominant. Don McPherson at Syracuse, and Steve Taylor, Nebraska. Jamel Holloway down at Oklahoma, who's injured, but great players all.
Lockwood, who really can charge off the blocks, is to the 30. A gain of five, maybe six. It'll be third and five. Lockwood now with 42 yards rushing. And a big third down with 10 minutes left in the game. Percy Snow has another tackle for Michigan State.
Percy Snow will tell you, though, if he doesn't lead the team in tackles, he's not playing well. This defense designed to keep him free.
Shoots him.
Henry, who had a touchdown reception of 33 yards early in the second half, and Pete missed him by a stride.
Starting with Henry was number 36.
Going to try another field goal. Yes, this time instead of Rodriguez, it's going to be Affolder to try the field goal.
Breaks up fourth down, fourth floor, 30.
Affolder, who kicked one 64 yards, then a national scholastic record while in high school. Another fake. McLean. First down at the 22. Now that shows something from Larry Smith. Did he fumble? No, after he was down. Smith trying two fake field goals in the last three, and it's not often when you're burned once, you'll come back and try it again.
When you need the big plays, you got to take some risks. That's exactly what they do here. They're working against the field goal blocking team. And even though they were alert and were ready for that play, they did not play the option well. With a quarterback in there, you have those options.
Oh, that looked like a fumble to me. That looked like a fumble. I'd like to see, there is one, and Pete falls on it. I wonder if we could go back and see the tail end of the play with McLean carrying. It appeared before he went down, somebody had reached in and snapped the ball out of his grasp.
Stripped that ball loose.
Meantime, Pete has that fumble on the exchange from center for no gain. Here's the tail end of that fake field goal. McLean, backup quarterback. Now right in here, they pull it away. Is he down?
That's Miller pulling it out, number 44. Crum also there, but
tough call.
Yeah, it is. Even the review may not have given that one up. Of course, you don't do that in college. We let him call it on the field here.
8.5 minutes remaining. Pete on second down. Into the end zone. Touchdown, Henry.
Defeat. That last blue stripe where it turns to white. Does he get those toes down?
Official right on the spot has a clear view of it, and he just got the toe down. Baryshnikov would have been proud of that catch.
He only needs one toe down.
A man, Ken Henry, who caught only one touchdown pass all year. The senior has two today. Rodriguez adds the extra point, and it's a 17-all tie. Let's take another look.
From the end zone, you've got a feeling for it here.
Can't really tell there.
Pretty hard to tell with that one.
Well, he just, if so, he just barely got that foot in bounds. Boy, if he'd polished his shoes, that would have been no touchdown.
Well, that takes on a whole new meeting. That's what Gene Autry used to do, right off into the sunset, the Golden West.
It's almost like a pyramid, those three spots of light that your blimp bring us those good pictures. What an incredibly clear and beautiful day here in Southern California.
Believe us, folks, it isn't always this way out here.
That's right. Think about that. And occasionally we had to get an earthquake out here today. I guess we ought to throw that in before you pack the car and head this way.
80 yards and 10 plays for Southern California to tie it. And out of bounds, 5-yard penalty.
Dick, we've talked a lot about SC tradition, running backs, the Rose Bowl, the horse, and black shoes. How many major college teams do you still see around the league, around the country, wearing black shoes? And no socks either. They've never worn the pull-up socks that have become so much a part of so many other uniforms.
Well, those black shoes, by just a wisp, keeping Henry inbounds and a touchdown that has tied it at 17 with 8.5 minutes left, and the Southern California kicking team tees it up. By the way, that touchdown, Merlin, was the first time Michigan State's defense has been scored upon in the fourth quarter since back in the Illinois game in late October when they were tied by the Illini.
Difficult to get yourself started again when you seem to have ground down to a stop, and that's what Michigan State appears to have done at halftime.
Gives it down, Craig Johnson.
Chased down by Dwayne Garner, number 9, and a flag goes down.
There's going to be a face mask call. Garner apparently reached in and got a hold of the mask, and that may be a 15-yard call, as it appeared that he used the mask to bring him to the ground. There's the, well, give the officials a chance.
Big Ten referee Gilbert Marchman has not indicated a personal foul, which would give it the 15. It's only a 5. State fans don't like that call.
We have gravity opening of the helmet, 5 yards.
So apparently didn't have a hold of the face mask. Watch it here. He reaches in and takes a hold of the, well, yeah, he does. Hard to tell whether he's got the mask or the helmet. Apparently the feeling was he had a hold of the helmet there.
Here it is from a reverse angle. Appears he gets into the helmet, then he slides it off onto the shoulder at this point. Although it looked and it did to us up here in the press box as it must have to most of the Michigan State fans that he really tore him down by the helmet. That was not the case.
Well, they're telling the Michigan State players and coaches they've got to move back behind the limits on the sideline. There's the, well, that sure looks like a face mask to me.
Might be right. You know, it's tough from that angle. And maybe he got from the mask down inside that shoulder pad right up in the neck there. I mean, that's
a tick. I once had a hold of a ball carrier, put him to the ground, and I saw the official throw a flag, and he said face mask, and I had a hold of the guy's jersey right under the mask, and I tore out a piece of the jersey. I said, here, this is what I had a hold of. I didn't have the face mask.
Did you win?
No. He said, too bad.
Now Michigan State leading most of this game has been tied by Southern Cal, and McAllister throws on first down, still on his feet, but then can't find a wide open Lorenzo White. Bill Stokes was the man that pressured McAllister.
McAllister's inexperience, although he was able to get away from the rush, he just had too much blood pumping through that system, overthrew the wide open receiver.
Well, the 3 completions have been for big yardage, one of them a 55-yard play to Risen that set up Michigan State's second touchdown.
Well, you've got 9 men committed to the line of scrimmage here.
White. Well, they've really stuffed the run in the second half, Southern Cal. Tim Ryan made that play.
Dick, basically what they have said to Michigan State is, we're not going to let you beat us running the football. You're going to have to throw the football. And they just come up and stack everybody on the line of scrimmage, and it's awfully hard when you're outmanned numbers-wise to get that running game going. You've got to be able to throw the football. And Michigan State's inability to accurately and successfully throw that football has really killed them here in the second half.
By going through the last 15 years, you could say that so often in these contests. McAllister throwing to Risen and caught at the 35 of USC.
SC players looking at the sideline and saying he was out of bounds, but I believe they're going to give the reception to Risen. I said earlier, this is a man that on the right team would be an All-American right now. Watch the feet. Is he in bounds? Well, he's in bounds until he touches out.
That's right. That's the old jump pass.
You bet. And he threw a strike. Well, what a nice throw here. We've criticized him for the bad plays out of the passing game. Let's give him his due. He's had some big, big plays here. And this may be one of the biggest, if not the biggest of the day.
A great athletic effort by Bobby McAllister, jumping out of bounds and firing to Risen. Here's Blake Ezor. And the sophomore has 2 yards before Scott Ross makes the hit.
We talked about Lorenzo White's cutback ability. Ezor, a change of pace runner. He is really a sprinter. And he'll get to the outside, slashing, try and get outside and get some yardage for you.
Risen can say, well, I didn't get an awful lot of them, but how'd you like the average? 45-yard average on his 2 catches today.
Not bad.
17 all under 7 minutes left in this fourth quarter. Ezor second effort, gets down to about the 27-yard line. Ross and Coet with the tackle.
Watch the quick acceleration of Ezor. Dick, you talked about his coming to Michigan State because of a friendship with his father. His father, Bernie, as you watch him use, I think he didn't ever go to the ground. They called him down, but I don't think he was there. His father, Bernie, said to George, I'm going to send my son out there, but you make sure he gets an education. And that was his first commitment, his first priority.
Highly recruited, perhaps the most highly recruited Nevadan football player since passer David Hum, also a native of Las Vegas. Timeout, 6 minutes and 16 seconds left. Always that powerful back in 1963, 25 years ago. That great game between Wisconsin and Southern Cal, eventually won by the Trojans. 43-38, Ron Vanderkelt in defeat becomes the memorable star in that game. In the dusk. Third down and five.
An audible call.
To Ezor for a first down. Keith Davis made the tackle for Southern California.
Surge of life. The Michigan bench here in the Michigan stands. Ezor running right into Mandarich. There is Blocker who's driven his man downfield. Again in behind the left side of that line for that critical first down.
Ezor stays in at tailback, gets the call again. Pressure legs. Holder from the secondary to make the tackle after another good gain, about five or six.
Well, we mentioned that you don't want to take a nap in that locker room, and this Spartan team slept through a good part of this second half, suddenly appear to be waking up. And with 5:33 and ticking down, a score tied at 17-all, there are some nervous stomachs on the USC sideline right now.
George Perlis has gone to a more straight-ahead runner in Ezor, but he doesn't get much on that time. As 64, Scott Ross, just a freshman again, makes another tackle. Tough call now for George Perlis.
I'll say it again, Dick. It's difficult to run that football when the defensive team is stacking everybody in there. I mean, they've got everybody, but the safety's right up at the line of scrimmage. There's Bobby McAllister looking to the sideline for the taking the signals.
The 25 second clock is at 10.
Morris Watts, offensive coordinator, getting that play out to him, sending him down through the signal system.
Third and five. Ezor sacked up, no gain. Dan Owens led the charge, number 90. 92, Don Gibson there as well. He's a freshman, Owens a sophomore. Here comes the field goal team on.
We have an SC player down on the ground as you watch the replay, running right into the teeth of that defense, slashing up into the middle, but not really going anywhere.
The one position at which Southern California is thinnest is defensive line. And that play involved two men, Gibson and Owens, and we can't as yet see a number.
Would appear that it possibly is Don Gibson, the nose guard. Dick, while we have a second here, one of the things that really impresses me, we've talked about the academics today. These two coaches, both Larry Smith and George Perlis, very committed to the academic growth of their players, and that's a high priority for them. When Larry Smith first came over from Arizona, the first three awards he established were academic awards, a top 10 award, an honorable mention award, and a most improved award academically. There you see, that's Dan Owens, number 90, going off this sideline. Good news as he trots off. But those awards have helped to boost the academic standards of his athletes on this football team, and that's a high priority.
To break the tie from 36, Langlow. Michigan State leads.
Thank you, Dwight.
Brown will look forward to that battle between number one and number two. And here at the Rose Bowl, number one has been the Pac-10 all but one of the last 13 games. Michigan State trying to end the drought for the Big Ten Conference has a 20-17 lead on freshman Langlo's 36-yard field goal. And here's his kickoff to another freshman, Irvin's at the five. Gets only to the 20. The Southern California trailing by three will start 80 yards away with 4:09 left. Donaldson made the tackle for the Spartans. Let's go back to the successful field goal and the emotion surrounding it.
They say for every reaction, or for every action, there is an opposite reaction. You see the elation on the Michigan State sideline, Michigan State kickers, and here's the reaction on the other sideline. One of disappointment, I'm sure. But watch how quickly Larry Smith recovered very quickly and said, let's go.
Rodney Pete underneath to his tight end, Paul Green, who was bumped out of bounds after a 7-yard gain. Green with a half dozen catches today. He had 24 during the regular season. Southern California, in fact, today, USC should win. It would be their 22nd bowl victory. Only Alabama has won more, the Tide with 22. And they play Michigan tomorrow on NBC.
Scott Lockwood limping off the field. Looks to have maybe injured an ankle.
So Ricky Irvin's will come in, a freshman at a position that is already critically thin. Steven Webster with the injury in the UCLA game, the top rusher in the Pac-10, not playing today. And Irvin's doesn't get anything on that carry. So it'll be third down, Southern Cal. Travis Davis, Percy Snow with the tackle.
Pretty difficult to question the kind of success that this USC football program has had in the last 25 years. You've talked about the Heisman Trophy winners, four of them, 9 Rose Bowl appearances, 5 national championships. Those pretty impressive credentials for a university.
Rodney Pete on third and 3. Gets the first down to the 35. Oh my.
You get a feeling for two things here: the athletic ability of Rodney Pete and the discipline of the Michigan State defense. They're staying with their people, and Rodney could see that. They don't break until the last second, until they cross the line of scrimmage, and then it was too late. He made the moves that you would see out of a good running back and picked up the first down.
Pete's 4-5 speed paying off, and now his arm gets it to Green. Short yardage out to the 39-yard line. As Pete made the traverse of the field on that reverse in the first down. Oh my, did he cover some hallowed Rose Bowl green. All the things that have happened and all the territory that he covered in one scramble.
I'm sure our good friend Leigh Leishman, who's watching this broadcast from home and has had such a powerful positive force on this Rose Bowl, would appreciate me telling you that that is natural turf down there. That's not painted green.
That's right, that is real green. Almost intercepted on the deflection intended for Affolder, and Travis Davis might have been the man that got a hand on it. Coming up next, the Oklahoma Sooners, the Hurricanes of Miami, here on NBC, number one and number two in the nation. The winner can claim the National Collegiate Football Championship, and you'll see it all. Don Crickey and Bob Trumpy waiting in Miami at the famed Orange Bowl.
Quarterbacks have to handle the heat. The heat's on Rodney Pete right now.
Third and 5. Scrambling again, and he's got some running room. To the Michigan State 37-yard line. Well, they said he had 4-5 speed, Merlin Olsen. I didn't think he was that fast. He can run with most anyone in this game.
taking advantage of the man-to-man coverage on this particular play. Defenders have run off with their people downfield, and Pete runs away from everyone. Is that Crum that finally came over and knocked him out of bounds? Yep, Todd Crum, but not until he had the big yardage and the first down.
He was out of bounds when that ball popped free.
Well, now the nervous stomachs are on the Michigan State side of the line.
A draw play to Irvin's, a freshman, to the 35. Short yardage with 2 minutes and 27 seconds remaining. And Michigan State holding a three-point lead.
Warren Bergen.
Well, we came here this Michigan afternoon State. Expecting one of the most contentious of all bowl games this year. Both teams so well matched. George Perlis still in a fighting mood.
I tell you, I think he can sense the fact that it's been an emotional drop. This Michigan State team that seems so fired up and so dominant in that first half has really kind of been hanging on by their fingernails here in the second half. They have managed to get a couple of field goals and certainly are ahead on the scoreboard. But Southern Cal has done a lot more productive operating on offense than they have in the second half.
We got to do it.
Oh, he's not happy at all.
Some of his predecessors, Woody Hayes, Bo Schembechler, would be proud of his sideline warfare. It appeared that Bergen was offside, number 45. The flags are down. So is Pete, but I think 45 Bergen jumped the gun.
Now, if he didn't, that's a huge loss, about a 15-yard sack. Yes, it is against Bergen.
Anticipating the count. And that'll be a disappointment for the senior who felt he had made a big play.
Well, he had. Just unfortunately doesn't count when you make it that way.
To the 30-yard line.
Offside on the defense.
That is one nice thing about college football, is when you make a mistake, they don't call out your number.
It did appear that Bergen was lined up at defensive left end, was a man who rolled offside. It's second down and two, 1 minute, 42 seconds left.
An opportunity perhaps for Rodney Pete to take a shot deep here. Nope, they fouled it off.
Who's got it? Michigan State! You said that the turnovers would be a key in this game. Southern California had the best record of any major college team, a plus 17 coming into this game. They're 4-0 against, and this one, most painful of all.
Rodney Pete just never got that ball up from John Katnick, his center. Now, I don't know whether he pulled out early or Katnick didn't get it out in time, but that really is a costly, costly fumble.
Todd Crum gets it for State. Well, you battle through an entire football season, you earn the chance to go to a bowl game, and the traditionally greatest bowl game of them all, the Rose Bowl. And the basic interchange from center to quarterback goes awry, and Michigan State stops the SC drive with 1:33 left.
But it's not over yet, and you just have the feel this has been a kind of a strange game. So many shifts of emotion in particular here in the second half.
Two timeouts, all that remain for Southern Cal as they try to tackle the ball. It's Blake Ezor on the carry, and timeout quickly by Southern Cal. They have one left, 1:26 remaining. And they're 86 seconds from a rare Big Ten win in the last 20 years. Ezor,
hangs on to it at the 30, and the final timeout is spent by Southern Cal.
Easy.
They don't know how to play football out there.
Let's play Army or play Notre Dame or someone. And then it leveled out in the 60s, 5-all. And then it turned in 1970. Only two Big Ten wins until this year from the 70s and 80s. And George Perlis, slight underdog Michigan State, is apparently going to celebrate the seven-year itch, but he's not about to scratch too hard yet.
He's not going to dig on anything until this thing is over. You still have the potential of a turnover, and I'm sure that Southern Cal's defense is going to be stripping at that football. No question about it. Chuck, Chris Allen's defense have been told, if you get a shot at that ball carrier, hold him up and let somebody else come and try and knock that football away.
Michigan State gains 3 yards. They have a first down, and this one's over. Ezor, going to be close.
Ezor, the ball carrier.
I don't think he's got it, Dick. I think he's going to be a little short.
Carrier, Colder.
Cleveland Colder, that hard-hitting sophomore safety. And time ticking away.
They're going to measure it. Do we have an injury? We have an injury.
Michigan State left. And now they'll wind up the clock. Now Michigan State does not have to kick the ball for 25 seconds, so they can let 25 run off the clock. They shouldn't be penalized because of the Colder injury.
No, they'll do it. They'll simply let it run down. May even take the penalty, which they're not going to worry about.
And with a kicker like Montgomery, knowing that he gets hold of a good one, he can drive you 60 yards back, they'll just let the 25 tick away.
And that's exactly what they're going to do.
There it is. 41 seconds left. 10 men on the line of scrimmage. Montgomery drills it. Tanner to the 19. Out of bounds at the 25. Of course, Tanner didn't need to get out of bounds. As soon as he would have been tackled, the clock would have stopped. 49-yard kick under pressure, Montgomery. 6 yards on the return. 31 seconds left.
Trying to block the kick that way. Once he got it away, there was really no one to block for Tanner. Tanner did what he could. It wasn't a great deal, and Rodney Pete is looking at a lot of green. 75 yards and 31 seconds, no timeouts. Those are pretty tough circumstances.
And for a tying field goal, you have to figure to get to at least the 30-yard line. To the sidelines, to Jackson, out of bounds at the 39. 13 yards, Pete to Jackson.
The conservative nature again. Of course, you'd expect it in long yardage situation here. 5 DBs on the field. 6 DBs on the field.
Now, the thing that George Perlis's defense is being reminded of, don't look so much for those little outs to stop the clock that you forget about the deep one.
Well, I think you'll find those two safeties at about 15, 18 yards before the ball is snapped. 15, 16.
Now they back off another 5. Pete going deep down the middle.
Ooh.
Harris and Crum, the two safeties, were in position for an interception, but almost knocked it away and into the arms of Affolder. Miller was the man who got it. And Crum was there as well.
I think if Miller hadn't touched that football, that Crum would have intercepted it, Dick.
I agree.
But those are the two safeties we talked about, and they're using their heads. They're not going to let a receiver in behind them. Perlis feeling a little more confident at this point. That's Chuck Stobart, the offensive coordinator that Larry Smith stopped to talk to there.
Deep throwing, incomplete, and a fine play by Kurt Larson, number 3.
Larson had a complete knee reconstruction last year, fought awfully hard to get back into this game, and has made some big plays today. Boy, there's some discouragement as you can look into the huddle. One of the brightest countenances of any of the athletes I've ever met, Rodney Pete. Well, he's not going to be very happy at the outcome of this game.
Two interceptions and the fumbled snap, which now looms as the biggest play. Way up in the air for grabs. Michigan State has it, and they now can genuinely celebrate
The Big Ten has come to Pasadena and will go home a winner. With a final reminder with 3 seconds left, don't let the celebration get in the way of a mishandled snap and a fumble.
I think it's what he's telling McAllister, just take that ball and lay down. You don't have to do anything at this point except make sure you don't fumble the football.
Flags go down.
Offsides, and I think they'll wind the clock after that, won't they, Dick? I don't think you can stop it with a penalty.
They'll mark it off, wind the clock, and then George Perlis can scratch.
Well, George knew he had the itch. He had the itch to win, as have all these Big Ten teams.
With 3 seconds.
I reset it, and I think they'll just open it up and let it tick.
For Rodney Peake and a young Southern Cal team, as is this Michigan State team. Both clubs lose very few through graduation. They'll go into the next Big Ten and Pac-10 seasons as the early favorites. They'll both be very strong again.
We have 3 seconds remaining in the ball game. We have a dead ball foul, encroachment. First down.
And Percy Snow, the middle linebacker, the sophomore from Michigan State, appropriate with 17 tackles. And a man with the name of Snow from the Midwest. No one thought him out.
Michigan State, 20. Southern California, 17. Outstanding player of today's Rose Bowl game, Lorenzo White from Michigan State, Rodney Peake from Southern California. Budweiser will donate a total of $2,000 to the general scholarship funds of Michigan State and USC. The stars coming in produced today, but it was White with his great first half and then a Michigan State team that played without mistake that earned the win.
Rodney Peake on the far sideline, I'm sure, with some real pain in his heart. Some very big, big plays on the day. But Michigan State fought, clawed their way to get to this game. They hung on through this second half. They walk away with a well-earned victory. And you're right, Dick. Fewest mistakes really paid off in this game.
And I thought I saw George Perlis look to the skies, wondering if that Irishman Duffy Doherty was finally smiling. That's